well, I'm about 3 months short of 90. The thing that bothers me now is my gait has been altered a little bit. I'm a little shaky.
When George Hage walks around his apartment, sensors track his every move, not his face or his identity, just his movements.
We have passive infrared motion sensors that are scattered around the home.
Hage is one of a number of residents at the Senior Living Tiger Place Apartments in Columbia, Missouri, where they are helping test whether these sensors can help solve an age-old, old age problem.
The goal is to keep people in their own homes as healthy and independent and functionally active as possible.
With support from the National Science Foundation and a White House initiative called U.S. Ignite, computer engineer Marjorie Skubick and nursing professor Marilyn Rance at the University of Missouri are using next-generation high-speed networks to remotely pinpoint subtle changes in an older person's everyday movements. They are monitoring for health problems or distress.
If I ever fall here, why, they'll know that somebody's on the floor.
So the hydraulic bed sensor fits underneath the mattress, so it's completely non-invasive.
They're testing new sensors under the mattress to measure a sleeper's heart and breathing rate.
He wakes up about the same time every day, and he goes to bed about the same time every night. It's a very consistent schedule.
Once a pattern is established,
we look for changes in the sensor data patterns that may correlate with changes in health.
If there's a change, an email is sent to a caregiver and a nurse checks in with the resident.
It could be a change in bed restlessness. It could be a change in their heart rate overnight. It could be a change in their respiration.
For example, frequent trips to the bathroom could be an early sign of a urinary tract infection.
The problems are much easier to solve when it's early. Urinary tract infections and other infections in older people often lead to sepsis. That's a blood infection, and that leads to an ICU stay or death.
Skubick expects this technology to be on the market in the near future, and not just to keep tabs on the elderly. She says it will be widely available to anyone with a chronic health condition who would like some extra monitoring at home. For Science Nation, I'm Miles O'Brien.